That I think is very important, and hopefully this will help people out. All right, so today is Sunday. I think it's February 5th. This is my Carolina Bell peach tree. Hold on, Amazon done came. Hold on. Sorry about that, y'all. Amazon came whipping around in my driveway all crazy. But anyway, this is my peach tree, my one and only peach tree. It's a Carolina Bell. The peach I got off of this was really good. I got jacked by some squirrels, but that was in a different video. This was in a pot, and now it's in the ground, so I'm hoping that it'll take off and be more productive. If not this year, then next year. But I'm doing this video because, like I said, it's early February, and we already got buds swelling up on this tree. This is good, but it's not good at the same time. I'm really nervous about that. It's good because it shows me that the tree, that this peach tree survived the winter, and it also survived being transplanted from the pot into the ground during the cold season. So that's cool. I'm happy about that. But I'm nervous because it's early and it's already budding. You know, I'm glad she's trying to be all fresh and frisky and be all productive. You know, she thick. But at the same time, we still have a lot of cold to go. We still got a lot of wind that's supposed to be hitting here, you know, just like it has been in a lot of the East Coast. You know, I think that a lot of the country's been hit by cold, period. I mean, it's February. Our last date, as far as like frost date, is not until mid-April. And so we still got like 2 months to go before we're, you know, kind of in the clear. And I think it was last year, even after the frost dates, like 2 weeks after frost dates, you know, people were planting stuff. And then it was like frost was just like pounding people even after those projected frost dates. So I am super nervous. I'm hoping that I don't lose all of these baby peaches. I know some people would say, you know, VA, maybe you should get another peach tree so that it can produce more, so that if you lose some, you'll have more, which is true. But I think more important than that, because I've seen single peach trees produce like, they say gangbusters, whatever that means, but y'all know what I'm saying. But more important than that, I think it's very important that we plant a variety of fruit, you know, not just one. So what I mean by that is, you know, just one example. Let's come over here real quick. And excuse the noise. Like I always say, traffic is insane. This is my apple tree. This is my pink lady apple. Now the apple tree, she's not budding like that. You know what I mean? So whatever buds or whatever fruit that she may produce this year, right now it's looking like it's gonna be safe because she's not producing early. You see what I'm saying? In these areas, and I've been doing a lot of plotting out little areas for other trees. A lot of these are spaces that'll be for fig trees. You know, we also have mulberry trees down here. I don't know if you can see that. You'll see it in the spring though, but there's baby mulberry trees that we've got planted here. Let's take a stroll and excuse the movement. As always, my little camera lady is a little bit too busy for me. That's all right. So in this area, we have persimmons that are not budding. You know, so what I'm saying is, like, don't just get one fruit tree. You know what I mean? Even if you have a small space, you know, you can get more than one fruit tree. Don't just get an apple, excuse me, don't just get one apple tree or like a bunch of apple trees, because if you, you know, just say something like that happens and they produce early and because of weather-related situations, you lose all of your apples or you lose most of your apples. You're without a harvest until the following year. Now you gotta wait till next year. You know what I mean? Don't just get like one peach tree or just a bunch of peach trees and nothing else, because if your peach trees break out in a disease, you're pretty much out until, you know, the following year. And then you gotta hope that things are more productive, or things are, you know, productive and not messed up like they were the previous year. You know, if you, even if you have a small space, you got, you know, space on a patio and you want a fruit tree, do two fruit trees. Get two pots. You know, get one pot and put, you know, if you like apples, if that's your thing, then put one apple tree in there. Then in the other pot, put another fruit that you may like, or another fruit that you know will be productive. You know, peaches are very productive and they produce early. You know, I always advise, like, you know, if you're not allergic to peaches, then get a peach tree. But, you know, another fruit that's very productive is mulberry. You know, get a pot and put a dwarf mulberry tree in there. You know, they'll produce, and here's another dwarf mulberry. They'll produce like crazy and you can keep them small. This is a dwarf mulberry. Got these mulberries from Dan Permaculture Food Forest. Shout out to him. But have one apple tree and one fig tree. You know, that way if something happens to your apples, you still have a chance with your figs. This is one of the places where I buried my figs to try to protect it from the cold. I'm trying to ensure that if I don't get nothing else, I get at least a few fig trees producing this year. You know what I mean? So just kind of think about that. Like I said, even if you have a small space, you know, well, VA, I only have like a little amount of, you got trees that you can keep small. You have dwarf trees and trees that you can keep very small. You can get a fig tree, like a regular size fig tree, just keep it cooled down and it'll produce. It'll still produce at a small size. You just have to stay on top of pruning. If you keep it in a container, it's only going to get but so big anyway. You know, so get more than one variation of fruit. Don't just limit it to like one fruit or one type, because that's really, apples are my favorite, or peaches are my favorite. That's cool. But the key is, you know, or the objective is, you want to be able to produce, even if it's blueberries. Like, we got blueberries back here. You know, just say you have a pot and you have an apple tree, your apple tree lost its fruit. You know, put some blueberries in another pot. You know what I mean? And at least you'll be getting something. So hopefully we won't lose the peaches, and hopefully y'all who are going through the same thing that I'm going through with your fruit trees, hopefully you won't lose them. I know last year a lot of my blooms, I lost some wind, and we've been having torrential winds out this way, and we've got more to come. You know what I mean? So hopefully I won't lose them all, but if so, you know, I have other fruit trees that I can count on, or that I can try to count on. We'll see what happens though. But that's my advice for everybody who's interested in growing fruit trees, or people who are growing fruit trees. You know, add variation to it, just so that you can keep, so that you can keep your probability of getting some sort of a yield a bit higher than what it would be if you only had one. All right, this went on long enough. Peace.